Hi, I'm Dr. Tracey Marks, a psychiatrist, and I make mental health education videos. This is a follow-up of a video that I did last year on using mushrooms to treat depression. The chemical compound found in the mushrooms that give it its therapeutic benefit is psilocybin. Although psilocybin shows the most promise, it's not the only psychedelic being studied. Here's a rundown of the different psychedelics and why people are excited about this. Psychedelics activate the serotonin 5-HT2A receptor in the brain. Antidepressants and the atypical antipsychotics also affect this receptor, but in different ways. Psychedelics are a class of drugs that cause hallucination experiences and altered states of consciousness when you consume a normal dose of them. And this is in contrast to alcohol, where you have to consume a lot of it and become intoxicated to have an altered state of consciousness. The common psychedelics are psilocybin, found in mushrooms, N,N-dimethyltryptamine, or DMT for short. This is a compound that's found in ayahuasca. Hopefully I'm pronouncing that right. Ayahuasca is a tea found in the Amazon forest, not the online retailer. One of the plants that makes up the tea has monoamine oxidase inhibitor properties. The MAOIs are an older type of antidepressant that are very good, but they have certain food interactions. So just be aware of this if you decide to drink some of this tea on your own, that you make sure that you're not eating foods or taking medications that could interact with the tea. Another plant-based psychedelic is mescaline, found in the peyote cactus and a few other cacti. These three are naturally occurring psychedelics. A synthesized drug is lysergic acid diethylamine, known as LSD. Ketamine is a psychoactive drug that was originally approved for anesthesia and is now being used to treat depression. Ketamine causes altered states of consciousness and hallucinatory experiences, but the effect is very temporary, lasting maybe hours on average. So it's not included in the list of classic psychedelics. Ecstasy is the compound MDMA. The FDA granted approval for it to be studied in the treatment of PTSD. So among this list, psilocybin has led the pack in the push to get it approved for clinical use. Currently, psilocybin is a Schedule I drug, which means that it's illegal to use and possess. It can only be used for research purposes. Drugs are classified in the United States by a schedule system rating the drugs by addiction and abuse potential. The next level down is Schedule II, which includes drugs like opioid pain medications and the stimulants that we use for ADHD. The drugs on this schedule are legal, but they're highly regulated by the Drug Enforcement Agency. As an aside, cannabis is also a Schedule I drug that's illegal on the federal level. So we don't have any FDA-approved formulations for it, but individual states have made it legal, allowing for the distribution of medical cannabis only in the state where it's legal. But because it's not FDA-approved and illegal to prescribe, doctors can't write prescriptions for it that give you a dose, frequency, and information on how to take it. Instead, doctors can only approve the dispensing of it from a state-authorized dispensary. It's a complicated situation. But back to the psychedelics. LSD and ayahuasca have had quite a few studies for various disorders such as depression, anxiety, and alcohol use disorder. But psilocybin has made the most progress. To date, there's 59 trials registered with the Food and Drug Administration. You can see the trials by going to clinicaltrials.gov and search for psilocybin. Some of the trials are currently recruiting volunteers or will be recruiting soon. The companies USONA Institute and Compass Pathways were granted FDA Breakthrough Therapy Designation to get the drug approved for depression. Breakthrough Therapy Designation means that the approval process will be shortened and fast-tracked. Here's why psychedelic research has gone viral, with viral being relative to the research space. Psilocybin behaves like no other medication treatment we have. After one or two doses, people in the studies reported positive changes in mood, attitude, and behavior that lasts months to years. In a 2008 study, many people reported 14 months later that the psilocybin was the most personally meaningful and spiritually significant experience of their lives. That's profound. Some people have referred to the treatment with psychedelics as having an inverse PTSD effect. With PTSD, you have a single exposure to something traumatic that has long-lasting negative mental effects because of the way the experience rewires your brain. Your amygdala gets activated to respond to triggers with intense fear. Similarly, with the psychedelics, one dose has shown to have long-lasting positive effects on your worldview, your attitude, mood, and behavior. It almost feels unfair to talk about this when it seems so good, yet it's not available. The only way around this is to participate in the trials if there is one in your area and if you're eligible. You can inquire about the various trials by going to the clinicaltrials.gov site and search for studies that are recruiting and enter the drug that you're interested in. You can even search by your country. These trials are not the same as the trials used to get FDA approval. These are research studies that contribute to the body of knowledge that's used to support the use of a drug for a certain purpose. One positive study doesn't establish clinical use. These studies have to be replicated. And most of the studies are done by universities and institutions and not drug companies. But once a treatment approach has been shown to be effective in multiple large trials, then there's a push to make that treatment a standard. Then a drug company has to apply for a new drug authorization and conduct their own trials to build on the research that's already out there. So that's how it works. Compass Pathways is one such company that is doing trials to get their version of psilocybin approved for treatment. You'll see their trials on the clinical trials site, but you can also visit their website to see what they're doing and apply to participate in their trials. USONA Institute is another company that's pushing to get approval, and you can go visit their site as well. So I'm hopeful that as we see more long-term psychiatric effects of COVID infection and pandemic effects, that this drug will get approved and make a world of difference very quickly with long-lasting impact. So, fingers crossed on seeing some real change here. See you next time.